In this class, we are going to study number theoretic functions. Some of the functions we have already studied in the last lecture, but I would like to revise Mobius mu function again in this lecture. So, what is Mobius mu function? Mobius mu function, which is denoted by as mu n, is defined like this. Mu n is 1 if n is equal to 1. And mu n is 0 if p square divides n for some prime p, and mu n is minus 1 to the power r if n is square free, that means n is equal to p1, p2, pr, where pi's are distinct primes. For example, mu 1 is 1, mu 2 is minus 1, because 2 is the only prime, it comes under this, mu 6 is 1 because 6 is equal to 2 into 3, so there are 2 primes, so minus 1 to the power 2, therefore mu 6 is 1. Mu 4 is 0 because 4 is equal to 2 square, so 2 square divides 4, so mu 4 is 0. We can easily show that Mobius mu function is multiplicative function. Now let us see this result. For each positive integer n greater than equal to 1, we define summation mu d, where d runs through the divisors of n, positive divisors of n. Summation mu d is equal to 1 if n is equal to 1, and it is 0 when n is greater than 1. Let us try to prove this result. Let us take n greater than 1. So put capital Fn is equal to summation mu d, d divides n, let n is equal to p to the power k. Then positive divisors of p to the power k are 1, p, p square, p to the power k. They are k plus 1 in numbers. Therefore, f of p to the power k is equal to summation mu d, where d runs through the positive divisors of p to the power k. So this is equal to mu 1 plus mu p and so on up to mu p to the power k. So what is mu 1? Mu 1 is 1. What is mu p? Mu p is minus 1. Mu p square is 0. Mu p cube is 0 and so on. All are 0. So 1 plus minus 1 is 0. Therefore f of p to the power k is 0. So what was this result saying? This was saying summation mu d is 0 when n is greater than 1. So we took n greater than 1 and proved that f of p to the power k is equal to 0. For example, let us take n is equal to 10. So divisors of 10 are 1, 2, 5, 10. Summation mu d, d runs through the positive divisors of 10. So this summation is equal to mu 1 plus mu 2 plus mu 5 plus mu 10. Mu 1 is 1, mu 2 is minus 1, mu 5 is also minus 1, and mu 10 is 1, because 10 is equal to 2 into 5, so minus 1 to the power 2. So this will be 2 minus 2, which is 0. Next, this is one of the most important formula in number theory. This is Mobius inversion formula. Let us see what is this. Let capital F and small f be two number theoretic functions related by this formula. Capital F of n is equal to summation f d. D runs through the positive divisors of n. So we can say that capital F n is the sum function of f. So if you have two functions which are related by this formula, then we have f n is equal to summation mu d f of n by d, which is same as summation mu n by d f of d. Or this can be said like this: any number theoretic function can be expressed in terms of its sum function. So this f was sum function, and this f we have written it as in the terms of sum function. Let us prove this. How do we prove it? First, we can see that these two sums, this and this, which are given in this conclusion of this theorem, they are same when we replace d by d dash. D dash is n by d. So d is the divisor of n, so is the d dash. D dash is also the divisor. Also, we can easily verify this result. D divides n and c divides n by d if and only if c divides n and d divides n by c. If you take this condition, you can easily find right hand side, and if you take right hand side, you can easily find left hand side. So this is easy to verify, so we are going to use this result. So what is here? Left hand side fn is summation, this is summation mu d f of n by d, summation mu d f of n by d. So this is equal to summation d divides n within bracket mu d as it is. So what is your capital F? Your capital F is this summation f d d divides n. So this is summation f c, c divides n by d. Here we have written fd, but there we have written fc, c divides n by d. So next, summation d divides n within brackets summation c divides n by d mu d into fc. This is equal to summation c divides n, then within bracket summation d divides n by c fc mu d. We are using this result, which is equal to summation c divides n within bracket fc summation mu d. D is the divisors of n by c, and we know this result. We have already proved this result earlier, which says that summation mu d is 1 when n is 1, which and it is 0 if n is greater than 1. So this part we are going to solve, summation mu d, d divides n by c. So this will be 0 when n is greater than 1, that is here n by c. In place of n, here we have n by c. So when n by c is greater than 1, then it will be 0, and when n by c is equal to 1, it will be equal to 1. So therefore, by this result, summation mu d, d divides n by c will be 0 everywhere except when n by c is equal to 1. And when n by c is equal to 1, that means n is equal to c. Thus, summation of fc, summation mu d is equal to summation fc into 1. C is equal to n. All others are 0. So, which is equal to f1. So, this was Mobius inversion formula. Now, we can see that tau n and sigma n can be described like some functions. Tau n is equal to summation 1 d divides n, and sigma n can be written as summation d divides n d. Therefore, by Mobius inversion formula, because tau n and sigma n here we have written tau n and sigma n like some function that is like this. So so here we have 1 is equal to summation mu n by d tau d d divides n, and n is equal to summation d divides n mu n by d tau d. And these two results are valid for n is greater than or equal to 1. This we got by Mobius inversion formula. What was our Mobius inversion formula? It was when f is the sum function of f, then f can be written as in the terms of sum function. So here first we wrote tau and sigma as sum functions, and then by that inversion formula we got 1 is equal to this and n is equal to this. Next result is this. It says that if f is a multiplicative function and capital F n is equal to summation f d, d runs through the positive divisors of n, then f is also multiplicative. That means f is given multiplicative and we have to show that this f is multiplicative. Earlier we have seen the opposite result. There we had the result like this, that if this f is multiplicative, then prove that capital F is multiplicative. But now we have reverse. Here this f is given to be multiplicative and we have to show that small f is multiplicative. Let us try to prove it. So what do we do to prove that a function is multiplicative? We do like this. We take f of mn, where mn and n are relatively prime, and we show that this is equal to fm into fm. So first, f of mn is equal to summation mu d f of mn by d. This is by Mobius inversion formula, because your capital F is given in terms of some function. So small f we can write by Mobius inversion formula. So here GCD of m and n is 1. We have taken them to be relatively prime. So this is equal to summation mu d1 d2. D we have taken as d1 d2. Here d1 divides m and d2 divides n. F of mn by d1 d2. So this is done, this reasoning is given here. Any divisor d of mn can be written as d is equal to d1 d2, where d1 divides m and d2 divides n. D1 and d2 are relatively prime. So this thing is equal to summation mu d1 f of m upon d1 into summation mu d2 f of n by d2. So this is equal to this we have done. Why? Because we already know that mu is a multiplicative function and capital F is given that it is a multiplicative function. So we have used these things. And what is this? This is equal to your small f of m and this is equal to f of n. So hence we have shown that this f is a multiplicative function. So now we are going to solve this problem. It says that if n is a square free integer, n is a square free integer, then we have to show that tau n is equal to 2 to the power r. Tau n is equal to 2 to the power r, where r is the number of prime divisors of n. So n is a square free. That means n is p1 into p2 into pr. They all are prime numbers and they all have powers 1, not more than 1, because n is square free. They all are distinct primes with exponent 1. So what is your tau n? Tau n is equal to k1 plus 1 into k2 plus 1 and so on up to kr plus 1. This is, we already know this formula. So here k1 is equal to 1, k2 is equal to 1. These powers, they all are 1. So tau 1 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 r times. So this is equal to 2 to the power r. Next problem is, we have to show that summation of 1 by d, d runs through the positive divisors of n, is equal to sigma n by n for all positive integers n. D is a divisor of n if and only if n by d is a divisor of n, because d multiplied by n by d is n. So we can say this implies that